All right, so Jared vehemently wants to talk about Skip Bayless. Yeah. Rel can't wait to go in on him too. So Jared, I'll let you start it off. Rel, you can chime in on that. Go.
Jared, first off, fuck Skip as a staff, a record label, as a motherfucking crew. That's one. Two, that's some insensitive bullshit that he gonna spew out there on the freaking national television. Talking about, oh, because he's the quarterback of America's team. He can't be in therapy. Get the fuck out of here. What the fuck made this nigga judge, jury, executioner of people's fucking life, yo? Like, he's a man like anybody the fuck else. Who the fuck does he think he is? Talking about, oh, well, you know, I think he had this before COVID, before his brother. Who gives a fuck when he had a mental breakdown or had depression? It's depression. It's a mental thing, brother. It should be praised that he fucking even admits that, because not most men will admit that they're going through shit or that they're even talking to somebody trying to address this shit. Plus, it's September. It's his National Suicide Awareness fucking month. Who the fuck do you think you are to come out here and talk about, oh, that's not a cool move? Fuck out of here. I don't give a fuck what team he prays.
During Black Lives Matter.
He plays for. I don't fuck if it was the Dolphins. I don't care if it was the fucking Ravens. I don't give a fuck what team it was. Like, bro, it does that whole, oh, because it's America's team. So you trying to say America's team has to be a bunch of fucking
robots?
Basically. Fuck out of here, yo. You a bum ass nigga for that shit, yo. And I hope, and I know Skip ain't probably gonna see this, but if you do see this, fuck it.
Yo, yeah. So I mean. Yeah, I pretty much echo all of that. My thing is with Skip Bayless, like, I know Skip Bayless is an established professional. Like, he knows what he's talking about, and I think he does his job well, but I can't fuck him because he's a hater. So before all of this happened with the whole Dak Prescott shit, it's like, he's just a super hater. Like if he doesn't like the player, he'll look at the performance and be able to pinpoint everything that went wrong. If he likes the player, but then Shannon show him all the bullshit that player did, now he got an excuse for everything, like what went wrong. Like when Tom Brady done fucked the whole game up like he did yesterday, Shannon is like, yo, if LeBron comb his hair the wrong way, well, he really can't do that well anyway. But if LeBron combed his hair the wrong way, you know, you're all over him. But when we ask about Tom Brady throwing interceptions, now it's about, oh, there was no preseason, and oh, there was this, you know, he's just a big hater, and I can't fuck with haters like that. But when he did this Dak Prescott shit, I'm like, bro, talking about I have no sympathy. How you have no sympathy for a nigga who brother killed himself because he was depressed? Like, that really? Like, I don't know if Skip got brothers or dealt with that type of death. Maybe he has, maybe he hasn't. But to say you have no sympathy for that, like, that's crazy. Like, that, I don't even understand how. That shows that you have no humanity. Like, that's when I saw that, I'm like, wow. Like, you really, that's some shit that, like, you feel inside, but, like,
you don't voice don't that
say,
shit.
Right, you don't say it, right? You know, you don't say it because, you know, that's just, like, some crazy, like, that's just craziness. Like, it's, and the thing is, too, he don't believe nobody get hurt. Like, when somebody get hurt, he'd be like, yeah, and he kind of had that sort of injury. Like, no, niggas be hurt, and he don't even believe that. You know what I'm saying? And now people got dead, depressed brothers, and he said that's not even an excuse. I don't feel no sympathy. Like, what kind of person is that, bro?
Because it's his fucking team, and his team needs to be a fucking team of whatever the fuck he thinks that shit is. Like, get the
it's not just his team; it's America's team.
First of all, the Cowboys ain't even shit since I was like 10 years old. So
we need to stop all that. And how did they become America's team? Because they have a star at the logo? Like, I don't understand.
Yeah, that's one thing I always wanted. I never agreed upon that.
There was no general
was that on the census? Saying, hey, was that on the census? I don't know.
Democrat, like, Republican, Cowboy fans. Like, yeah.
I always wondered how that became America's team. Like,
it was based on TV ratings because they was always on TV, and at the time, a lot of fans gravitated towards them, so they became a popular team across.
But even the Braves were baseball's America's team.
Yeah. At one point.
I think they probably still are, because nobody calls anybody else America's team. So,
and I don't think anybody says that in baseball.
Yeah, basically,
nobody uses that term. I mean, because Dallas basically uses that term for their marketing. Because, like Moe said, they haven't won anything, so they have to use that to keep promoting. That's why I think. I think in football they're the highest value team. I think or team. The Giants.
Yeah. No, it's Cowboys.
Same thing.
The Cowboys, Giants, and then Steelers after that.
Yeah, and same like the Knicks is the highest because of MSG and all of that, and they call it MSG the world's famous arena. It's not, but they call it that. So it's part of marketing and promo. It's just, you know.
We were just talking about propaganda earlier.
Propaganda. That's what it is. Right. That's what it is. You know, that's why they got that term.
I get it. But why
do they have a new stadium? The Cowboys, like they last year was like so dope. Like,
I don't. Do they have a new stadium?
SoFi. They played the SoFi Stadium.
Oh, okay.
Oh, the Rams got the new stadium.
Oh, the Rams. Okay. Cowboys shit ain't even 10 years old yet.
Yeah, they still got the second to the Giants. They have the highest value stadium, whatever, because. They have it's nicer, just the Giants got bad real estate dealers, so, you know. You know, paying rent in the swamp of the Meadowlands costs money.
For some reason. But still, that design is like, really?
We got the most blandest stadium ever.
Yeah, it just looks like a 1960s.
Like, they got, you know, the Falcons got a halo roof that opens and closes like an eye. Like, teams got Wi-Fi. Like, you could come right in, your ticket, and everything is just connected. You could order your food right from your phone. Like, they got all this cool stuff. We just got
the lights change blue to green
colors for the team that's playing today. And
because fucking Giant Stadium's looking like MTA fucking buses and shit.
like we got nothing. Like,
everybody got some new hot shit. We still working with the old shit.
Word.
Like, we're gonna do a paint job on the bench, but you know, that's about it.
Yeah, but
fuck Skip.
Back. Lou, Ben, y'all got anything to add on the Skip Bayless?
I didn't hear all that about him, like, I missed that part of it, but I have heard him say like ridiculous stuff before. it's part of his show, that's just what it is. I think he's purposely trying to push people's buttons to make you watch. So it's just part of his game.
Could be trolling, but that's
to me. I was about to say that. At this certain line, you don't cross. Shout out to Dak though, because as a man, as a black man, as a leader of a team, to come out and say that shit takes balls. You know, and he ain't got his money yet. Like, he ain't got his money. His bag is not even secure yet.
You shouldn't criticize anybody for having any type of mental problem. Like, come on, like,
especially during this time, it's bad taste on Skip's part. I get it. You like pushing the envelope. You like getting the fans riled up and people hype. But I mean, more shame on Fox Sports for just coming out with that generic. You know, we don't support him. Yet he's on TV the next day. Like,
I was gonna ask that question.
Give his ass a suspension at least. Like, put some effort into it. You know, like, hey, Skip, you shouldn't have said that. Like, I can say some crazy shit at work to a customer, and it can be goddamn well and needed. My boss is going to be like, all right, take a day and chill out, though, because I got to set precedent that I'm holding you accountable.
Of course.
Like, there was no accountability to it. Mm-hmm. He said it. All right. We apologize. We don't, you know, support
him. And they apologize, not even him.
Right. And him. Like, he didn't say anything to it. Like, there's just certain things you don't say. I see why ESPN was like, all right, go ahead, go. Because people like that, we don't need to see on TV. Like, I think about it this way. I have kids. They watch sports. Like, I don't want my kids seeing that to think, like, damn, if I say how I feel, is that how people going to react? Like,
yeah,
I might not say how I'm feeling now because I might be judged by people looking at me outside, or, you know, a recruiter or my coach might be like, you know, man up. We ain't got no space for that here. We don't live in those times anymore. You know, me growing up, that's what I got. Get up, boy. You know, you ain't bleeding. Get up. Go ahead, go. You know, there's no crying in baseball. You know, we all heard it. But it's a different game now. Like, we live in a different world. So very, very poor on Skip's part. If you feel that way, keep it to your damn self.
Yeah.
Like, Wait till TV timeout and be like, yo, fuck that bitch ass Dak for feeling that way. But I'm not gonna say that on TV because you're in a position of power. So fuck Skip, like Jared said, fuck him. I don't watch his show just because I just don't like him.
But you know, like I mean not to cut if Ben was gonna retort or you were gonna say something, but ESPN does have somebody like that, and his name is how did Kevin Durant phrase it? 2.3 rebound averaging Kendrick Perkins. And I forgot. Skip this say something. When Jalen Rose ethered him on TV talking about his high school stats or his college stats when he only averaged 1.6. Like Skip even said, I went through depression. So how the fuck you can't even understand that you can't accept depression. Like,
right.
Like, bro, like, you know how Dak is. Dak has all these commercials, the Chunky Campbell suit commercials with his brothers. You know how tight he is with his family.
Yeah.
Right. Bro, like, come on, man. Like, you know how this man feels. Like, he's a true family man. Yo, that shit's deep to him. Like, yes, we all have our share of, you know, of how we feel about COVID and how, you know, the things we see it done to people around us and maybe us directly, like, and you just, and you, and like, he's on equated by saying, oh, even during the pandemic, you know, everything shut down, but we didn't. We kept the show rolling, Shannon. Me and you, you remember? You would come to my house and we would record a show. It's like, who the fuck cares that you kept the show alive?
That's like, the same thing? That's like your brother dying from depression? That's the same thing?
Right, like, how the fuck is that compared to somebody family? Like, come on, man, get the fuck out of here.
That's crazy. Like, yeah, I mean, your brother died, but look, you see what we did? We gave him the word.
We didn't go see therapy. We didn't go out to get therapy trying to find help. No, we did it. We did it ourselves. Fuck out of here, yo.
It's not like Dak said, well, I'm not gonna play because of my break. He just said, like, look, man, I was going to do some shit, and I got, even if he said he wasn't going to play, still, he still don't say that. But Skip acting like he said, well, I don't know if I can do it anymore. Like, yo, all he did was admit that he went through, he was depressed, and, like, I don't see what's wrong with that.
What do you think about Fox Sports not doing anything about it?
That's bullshit. I mean, it's like Ben said, it's Fox, but yeah. That shouldn't be the scapegoat. Oh, it's Fox. Like there should be accountability held to it.
It should be, yeah.
It's like we agreed that yeah, you have freedom of speech, but at the same time, to your freedom of speech, we also said, you know, we don't agree to that at all. So it's
freedom of speech is a legal thing. So I don't think Skip should go to jail for saying what he said, but right. You know, but I mean, but it should be repercussions, you know,
I spin it this way. Wasn't Bruce Bowen fired for saying something negative about Kawhi before Kawhi was the Clipper?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it was, but yeah.
And it wasn't even something to this magnitude.
So it wasn't even that crazy.
And he got let go from a radio show. Like, mm-hmm. His face is not even on TV. So for somebody as popular as Skip Bayless is, for no repercussions to happen, could you imagine if it was one of our ESPN counterparts as of color? Imagine Jalen Rose said something like that.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't hear it. When did this happen?
It was last week.
Right before the season started.
Yeah. It was right.
Yeah, I haven't heard much about this. Like, so nobody made a big deal about it.
And that was what I was going to allude to because Fox released a statement, but that was it. Like, there was no uproar about it. There was nothing really about it. And
I haven't heard anything. Jared talking
about it. I think it was Friday's show.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was Friday's show because it was still because they could. I remember on the ticker, it was Toronto, Boston. Mm. So I think that game was Thursday. So yeah, I think it was a Friday morning show.
Yeah. There was no uproar. There was no, nothing.
Yeah.
Like, it happened. I seen a few people speak about it, and that was it. Like, it really didn't go anywhere.
It's a Skip being Skip kind of thing, which is bullshit.
It's just like saying, Fox being Fox. Like,
well, that or he got lucky. What else happened during that day that probably got overshadowed? You know what I'm saying? He just probably got lucky. Went under the radar. And
the booing. The Thursday the game, booing, yeah. The booing was still the news. And it's being back. So people just like, hey, we got football this weekend. What do you say? Yeah,
probably Trump said something stupid, I'm sure. So, like, come on. It probably just flew under the radar, I guess, because I didn't hear anything about it till you guys voted.
And I think that's the bigger issue. I think what he said is one thing, and the fact – I mean, I don't know. Maybe nobody's watching. I don't know. But that's their highest-rated show on Fox Sports, on FS1.
Right.
So – you know, maybe nobody's watching as much as, you know, maybe nobody cared. I mean, I don't know. Did Shannon say anything? Did he?
Shannon didn't rebut. Like, I watched the clip. Shannon didn't rebut.
Yeah,
like,
Shannon didn't really say nothing.
So,
he was like, he's like, y'all understand, you know, but, you know, you got to understand, Skip. You know, he loved his brothers. You know, understand that, Skip. Skip.
So, if Shannon don't say nothing, if Fox just issues their apology, he's protected. He know he can get away with saying stuff like that. Right. And that's the, you know, the overall, you know, that's what I'm getting from this. You know, not enough people probably are aware, like you said, right. In, you know, suicide awareness, and no one's saying you're doing this now. You're saying this kind of thing now that he's right. Speaking up for this, and you're going against what this month is about. And
right.
It's under the table.
Yeah, I think right now nobody's heard about it. I think there was more awareness, I think it would definitely be a big issue. But maybe he got lucky. Like I said, I don't really even know what happened on Friday as far as news-wise or anything as that.
Because it was enough for Fox to apologize for it.
Mm-hmm.
But that's it. Like, nobody really cared after that. Because, like you said, you still got the playoff basketball going on. You got NFL Week 1. Which seems to be more of a bigger issue than people's mental health, but, you know.
See? And not to mention the WNBA playoffs are starting. Huh? Huh? Whoa. Can't nobody think about nothing else but that.
Right.
But remember, that's what it was, too. I think Thursday was the first time in history, like, all the major sports was on at the same time.
In time, baseball, yeah.
Basketball, hockey, football.
Football
was like, yeah, that Thursday.
Soccer.
Everything was playing. So Skip was like, oh, they're not paying attention. We're going to talk about, you know, all the stuff yesterday. But by the way, I'm going to say some controversial stuff. And then next story, we're going to go right over, so.
Okay. Right, man, and you said it happened on a Friday over the weekend.
Yeah.
I didn't know, but I didn't hear nothing about it.
I think nothing. it should be bigger news. And if nobody noticed, then, yeah, that's the bad part. And the fact that Fox Sports didn't have to do anything, they didn't have to reprimand them because they like, nobody's watching.
Nobody noticed. Yeah, that's true. That's basically what happened.
We sorry. Moving on. Like, that's it. Yep. We covered. We did.
So when they say, when they come back to it, like, oh, no, but we said something.
Yeah, right. Let's say, for those that are watching,
just covered themselves.
We don't agree with, hey, the views and opinions of the guests on the host of the show are solely theirs. We don't agree with him, but hey, this is great TV. Keep it going. You know, that's
basically
that's what it is.